then one has to think about how to paint those things, how to put that them into your art, you know. So it's a journey also in that sense. Our culture is a very complex culture. Our society is a very complex society. There is not one way one can look at it. There are multiple ways. So there are multiple narrations. So there are multiple languages.
Lokesh, you were also speaking about a lot of social issues, social problems and political issues and spiritual aspects of it, as to how people react to it and how people understand spirituality. And you try to understand it, in fact, as we were speaking. So how do you reflect that in your paintings, and in what way do you want to present them to the people, as to the nuances of it, the complexities of it, or how we have to take it, how we have to take your painting, when you are addressing social issues? Because I've seen your painting, somewhere you have spoken about caste issues, somewhere you have spoken about the spiritual aspects of it, somewhere you have spoken about some religious structures which influence you, religious places which influence you.
Actually, what happens, I myself come from an upper caste Brahmin background. We are Deshastha Brahmin from Maharashtra, migrated to Madhya Pradesh. Now we live in Bhopal. So, and come from a very traditional background also, very religious background. I have seen life in a way where a lot of traditional things are happening around me, religious festivals or ritualistic things are happening around me. One of such thing which somewhere really pulled my conscious to think about was the thing of this hum usko bolte deviyana, the aspect of possession. One is possessed with, one calls it the spiritual possession, the divine possession. My mother used to go through it, so it's a very personal memory for me. As a very young boy, I have seen that, and so sometimes it was a difficult thing to see mother going through that kind of trouble or that kind of situation. But it is very normal also. It's not something out of blue, something happening in our society or in our families. It is very much part of many cultures, actually, not just our culture, but throughout India you can see or South Asian countries. In many cultures you can observe this aspect. One doesn't come up with certain issues or certain language immediately, or there is no such immediate response, at least in my art. It has taken time to understand things, or I have practiced in such a way that every time it is changing and coming up with some newer understanding of knowing the reality, or at least reality around me. So basically it's a continuous journey in which one realizes lot of small things. When one say issue, like when you asked social issues that takes place in my work, so issue is I don't know if one can term within that limit of issue the subjectivity, the subject in the work, because it goes much more beyond it, much more experiential reality, and as well as the learned reality or something that you have studied. Everything comes together in work, and sometimes you are critical about things, about the setup, but there are also times you learn from it and you try and discover something much more than what you have till now you had experienced, because something suddenly you see into it and you try to explore that aspect also.
Is it, you are also a writer, in fact. So the narrative part of it is generally or usually seen in writing. So even that has influenced your painting in some way. And what do you write about? What issues do you write about?
I write short stories, basically. Some long stories are there, frankly saying, till now I have not published, but perhaps soon something will get published. So in this, I write in Hindi my short stories, and yeah, in a way it reflect in, it's not that the writing is reflecting in the work, but because it is happening from the both simultaneously both ways it is happening.
Draw from each style.
Yeah, because the thought process is continuous. So there are things, sometimes everything you cannot paint. Every expression does not come across the way, at least I, it's not that one cannot paint everything, but one has a limitation. I have certain limitations for myself, perhaps I have constructed till now. I can break it tomorrow, but till now there are certain things I don't paint, but it comes very nicely when I speak or when I write, because finally it is language. Painting is also language, writing is also a language, and both have their own possibilities as well as limitations. So one try and explore those boundaries and possibilities, basically.
And you have also done films, rather you are in the process of doing films. So you have almost covered all the genre that is possible as far as visual art is concerned. So how do you relate to filmmaking, and what are you working on? You're working on a documentary on Ghulam Mohammad Sheikh, and you're also working on a documentary on the Dalit issues. So these are something that that is very close to your heart, because I have seen a lot of your paintings with social issues. So tell us something about it, even though they are not as yet ready for public, but tell us something about it.
Mm-hmm. I was a little hesitant to talk about this question, because as such the movies or the films that I am working on are not complete products right now. But yeah, I can tell a little bit about what I am doing. Recently, some months back, me along with my friend Mr. Kardam Bhatt, is much senior. He is also an activist, and he has worked a lot on Dalit front, especially in as far as the Baroda city is concerned. And his friend, who is also a Dalit Panther, Mr. Arvind Bhai, we call him Arvind Bhai, both of them are part of this documentary. Actually, we three of us are making this documentary. It's a small documentary, actually. It will be perhaps a small documentary, because we don't have any budget to make it. So we are using very small, not even this kind of camera, but we are using very still camera, which has some possibility of video and all. So what we are doing is basically, we are looking at the city of Baroda, and the history of city of Baroda from the perspective of, from the Dalit perspective, how Dalit life emerged in the city of Baroda, and the importance of that life, which is not very much actually out there in the media or in many other publication things. So there are lots of issues, but right now we are concentrating on the Antej Shalas. Antej Shalas were the schools which were opened for the untouchables and Dalits by Sir Sayaji Rao Gaikwad. He was the king, and he was equally a very well-known educationist. So he also established the MS University and all. And at that moment, he also started these in the Baroda state 300 schools for Dalits and untouchables, where the untouchables were only teaching and untouchables were studying, because the upper caste was not ready to even let these kids come in their classes and sit along with them or share their knowledge and everything. But we found it very important to take this issue and talk about it, because in our time also thinking about the caste issue and the reservation issue, it really, when one talks about it, it boils, actually. It boils in people's mind, and it generates a lot of heat, and one is not able to many times from the higher caste perspective, one is not ready to relate to or understand the difficulties or the difficult or the complex history. The question of the issue of reservation has gone through. It is very, very complex. So how to understand it? In a way, the way we are approaching it is to show we are interviewing people who studied in those schools at that moment, some who are alive, very old people, and also later on became teachers and principal of same schools or other schools, who are retired in their old ages. So we are taking their interviews and trying to work out if basically they are talking about their past, their memories, and how difficult. It's not that if the schools are established, it becomes easy, because the struggle goes on. Even now it is going on. So that is the area we are trying to bring into it.
लोकेश खोडकेचे तुम्ही विचार जाणून घेतले, चित्रकार कसो विचार करता, समाजाचे काही विषय जे कलाकाराक जे चित्रकाराक लागीच्यान असे लागता ते कसे तो हाताळटा आणि कसे तरेन तो मांडटा आणि लोकां मुखार किती सांगू सोदता आपल्या चित्रांनी हे जाणून घेतले. डॉक्युमेंटरी फिल्म मेकर तो डॉक्युमेंटरी करून तो किती दाखवूक सोदता हे तुम्ही जाणून घेतले. लोकेश खोडकेचे इंटरव्ह्यू तुमकां नक्कीच आवडला असला दुबाव ना. आमची आयची कार्यावळ हांगाच सोंपता. जर तुमचे कसले सजेशन्स असले आमकां ह्या पत्त्याचेर कळोवचे nagesh@prudentmedia.in. तर आमी परत मेळया फुडले बेरेस्तारा सांजवेच्या 7:30 वरांचेर. तो मेरेन पळयत रावात प्रुडंट मिडिया.